我们当路教会的弟兄姐妹大家早上平安。
Greetings of peace, very good morning to our members in Adam Road Church.
今天早上小调用我们在这几个早上我们所读过的这个读经进度我们来做一个分享。
I'd like to share based on our daily Bible reading.
我们已经进入到马太福音书了。
And we have started with the Gospel of Matthew.
我们已经进入到第四章了。
And we are now in Matthew chapter 4.
我们来回顾一下我们所读过的。
Let's revise what we have read.
记得吗？我们在上个礼拜嘛，我们应该是前个礼拜我们来开始我们的马太。
Last week we started the Gospel according to Matthew.
那我们有谈到耶稣基督的家谱。
We talk about the genealogy of Jesus.
就是在马太福音书的第一章嘛。
And this is recorded in Gospel of Matthew chapter 1.
那过后呢就谈到耶稣基督的降生。
And later on, we talk about the birth of Jesus.
那很特别。
And his birth was special.
因为天使来告诉玛利亚。
Because the angels appeared.And said to Mary.
当然这是记载在路加的一章的三十节。
And this is recorded in Gospel of Luke chapter 1 verse 30.
那我们今天来看我定了一个主题约瑟不要怕，其实是来自马太福音书的一章的二十节。
And the topic for today, Fear not Joseph, is taken up from Matthew chapter 1 verse 20.
当然约瑟会惧怕是因为他不知道神的这个大计划。
And Joseph was afraid because he was ignorant of the greater plan of God.
所以呢，我们今天我们来看一下到底约瑟怕什么。
What was it that Joseph was afraid of?
那我们在我们的信仰生活上，我们也会有惧怕。
And we also have our fears in our life of faith.
那我们要怎么去克服呢？
And how are we?To overcome these fears.
所以早上就定了这个题目，约瑟不要怕这是天使告诉约瑟的。
And we would like to use this topic, fear not Joseph. This is what the angel said to him.
那我们来翻开马太福音书的一章十八到二十五节。
In Matthew chapter 1, verse 18 to verse 20.
我们来读这一段。
We'd like to read this passage.
马太福音书的一章十八到二十五节。
Matthew chapter 1 verse 18 to verse 25. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was as follows. After his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with child of the Holy Spirit. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man and not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly. Verse 20. But while he thought about these things, behold,An angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit. Verse 21. And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. So as this was done, that it might be fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold,The virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us. Verse 24. Then Joseph, being aroused from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took to him his wife, and did not know her till she had brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus.
这边是一个很特别的事迹。
And this is a very special event.
当然马太也引用了以赛亚书的一个预言。
Matthew also quoted a prophecy taken from the book of Isaiah.
来应验了神在七百多年前所说的一个预言。
And this was to fulfill a prophecy of God made 700 over years ago.
耶稣基督的降生对我们的救恩是有绝对的关系的。
And the birthOf Jesus is absolutely related to our salvation.
所以呢，这个是非常重要一件事。
As a result, this is a very important event.
但是他选玛利亚借着圣灵让她怀胎。
And the Lord has chosen Mary, and she conceived through the Holy Spirit.
所以我们从这一段、啊、我们看到说、啊、原来玛利亚已经许配了给约瑟了。
And this passage also tells us that Mary was betrothed to Joseph.
可是为什么约瑟现在怕呢？
But why was Joseph afraid?
当然、约瑟我刚才有讲约瑟不知道神要在玛利亚的身上做大事。
And earlier I've said that Joseph was ignorant about the bigger things that God is going to accomplish on Mary.
我们可以看到在圣经、啊、有很多、这个不要怕、这个字眼。
The Bible has this phrase, do not be afraid.
比如说在路加福音书的一章十三节、天使、啊、告诉撒加利亚你不要怕。
And for example, in Gospel of Luke chapter 1 verse 13, the angel said to Zacharias, do not be afraid.、
那一章的三十节也告诉玛利亚说玛利亚你不要怕。
And chapter 1 verse 30 also tells us that Mary do not be afraid.、
那路加的二章十节、是天使来告诉这些牧羊人、说你们不要惧怕。
And in Luke chapter 2 verse 10, the angel said to the shepherds, do not be afraid.
因为当然了、突然间有天使来显现了、当然你会觉得说、这不是一件、常的事很常发生的事当然你会怕、
And it is natural that you'll be afraid because the angels appear out of nowhere.、it is not something that,、that you will normally experience.、
所以呢天使才说你们不要怕。
Which is why the angel said to them,Do not be afraid.
原来啊，这个惧怕这个事情啊，是我们每个人都会有的。
Fear resides in every one of us.
啊，没有一个人啊会啊、因为啊、一些事情，我们会很勇敢的去面对，不会的。
It is not usual that we face our fears or things with great courage all the time.
我们可以看到，这个约瑟跟玛利亚，他已经许配了，应该是应该许配了、
And here tells us that, that Mary was betrothed to Joseph.、
他们 有这个婚约了、
And they already had this marriage agreement.、
那看来一切都很顺利。
Appears that everything was happening smoothly.
那也看到说、他们有一些安排跟计划啦。
We also saw that they had some plans.
可是在十八节的这个下半段
But in the latter portion of verse 18,
约瑟就害怕了。
Joseph was afraid.
因为他现在看到说，这个许配给我的还没有过门，哎，已经怀孕了。
Because Mary was betrothed to him before they were married, is Mary already had a child?
啊，怎么可以这样呢
How can this happen?
应该是在婚约里面才有这种性的行为啊。
Because we can only have sexual relationship after.We are married.
那在婚姻之前不应该有性行为啊。
There should not be any sexual relationship before marriage.
约瑟不懂。
Joseph did not know.
这边讲得很清楚，是从圣灵怀胎的。
But here it clearly says that the child was conceived of the Holy Spirit.
可是约瑟不懂啊。
Yet Joseph did not know.
所以他整个。我相信他整个世界 他在他整个世界里面、应该是整个是崩溃了。
In the world of Joseph, he just collapsed.
所以他整个人就害怕起来了。
And that brought fear on him.
哦，这个还没有过门的这个妻子已经怀胎了。
How is it that this, the wife-to-be has not been officially his wife, and yet she's already pregnant?
我怎么娶过门啊？
And how am I going to take her as my wife?
所以呢，他就想说啊，要暗暗的把她休掉就好了。
As a result, he had a plan to put her away secretly.
我们很多时候啊，也像约瑟这样，在困难、在难处的时候，也有产生很多这种惧怕。
And we find ourselves in the shoes of Joseph often, when things happen to us, there's fear.That sees our hearts.
因为我们不知道神要在我们的身上所做的大事。
And this is also because we fail to recognize that God is going to do something far greater on us.
因为很多很多、不知道的因素啊，所以让产生很多惧怕。
Because of the many unknowns, it brings lots of fears.
所以今天早上我们要谈、几点有关。不要怕。
And we'd like to talk about a few points this morning regarding do not be afraid.
首先呢，第一点呢，就是不要怕，当你在失望的时候。
Do not be afraid when you are disappointed.
啊，十八节啊，看到说啊，好像是玛利亚做对不起约瑟的事哦。
In verse 18, it appeared that Mary had done something, that was not right, towards Joseph.
约瑟不知道玛利亚是借着圣灵怀胎的。
Joseph did not know that Mary conceived through the Holy Spirit.
他只看到那个结果，就是哎，他已经怀胎了。
He only saw the outcome, which is his wife-to-be was pregnant.
当然他很失望啊。
Of course, he was very disappointed.
怎么还没结婚就有孩子了呢？
How is it possible that before we are married and she already has a child?
当然我们也会教导我们的青年啊，你不要有婚前性行为啊。
And we teach our youth do not have sexual relationship before marriage.
这是淫乱的。
Because this is adultery.
这个是
this is fornication.
这个是这是不道德的。
And this is morally incorrect.
这个也是我们会教导我们的青年不要这样做。
And we teach our youth not to do these things.
当然你婚后你不可以有性行为啊，就是你的性趣只可以限制在你的太太跟先生而已，不可以别人哦。
After marriage, there should not be sexual relationship outside of your marriage.
要是有第三者进来，那个就是奸淫了。
If there is a third party, then that will be adultery.
那个就是死罪了。
And that is a sin unto death.
那可是约瑟在这样的一个情况底下，他不知情，他觉得他被判了，被玛利亚骗了。
And because Joseph was ignorant of these things, he thought that he has been deceived, he has been betrayed by Mary.
所以他很失望。
As a result, he was very disappointed.
很多时候啊，我们在面对事情的时候
，very often when issues arise for us，
事情我们看到有一些事情的时候，我们就会产生一些结果。
When we observe the things that issues that happen to us, we make some conclusions.
有些时候事情还没有完全的结束。
And but the fact is that the entire issue has not come to a conclusion yet.
可是我们已经判决说这个就是他的那个结果了。
But we have already drawn conclusion of the matter.
我们很多人会这样
And we are often like this.
没有把事情看完，没有把事情听完，我们只听到我们要听的，然后呢就下那个判断说就是这样了。
We only hear what we want to hear and make our own judgments before the entire matter has been concluded.
很多时候啊，是我们想多了。
And frequently, it is us who have been thinking too much.
所以也因着这样啊，也造成了我们不必要的一些创伤。
As a result, we bring unnecessary hurt upon us ourselves.
所以耶稣基督啊，在马太的七章一节这样讲。
Therefore, in Matthew chapter 7, verse 1,
马太七章一节说啊，你们不要论断人，免得你们被论断。
Judge not, that you be not judged.
所以很清楚啊，我们应该要知道的是说，当事情还没有圆满的解决的时候，让我们不要那么快的去下那个定论。
Clearly, this is to tell us that before the conclusion of the matter, let's not make judgments.
因为会产生啊不必要的一些惧怕。
Because if you do so, you cause unnecessary fear to come upon you.
我们回到约瑟的跟玛利亚的这个事迹啊。
Let's return to this incident of Joseph and Mary.
当这个约瑟在忧虑的时候，
when,
在担心的时候，
when Joseph was worrying.
其实啊，神就是在他的人生中啊，来制造了一个美好的一个计划。
God had created a beautiful plan for his life.
我们再读下去。
If we continue reading on,
二十节
，in verse 20,
他说：“正思想这事的时候，有主的使者向他梦中显现，说：‘大卫的子孙约瑟，不要怕，只管娶过你的妻子玛利亚来，因为她所怀的，怀孕的是从圣灵来的。
But while he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit.
所以这个告诉我们啊， 玛利亚并不是跟另外一个男生发生关系所生出来的啊，这个孩子啊，所怀胎的孩子啊。
This tells us that that Mary conceived not through a relationship with another man.
并不是啊，约瑟所想的，并不是众人所想的。
And this is not what Joseph has been thinking about.
并不是她是一个淫乱的，或者是一个啊不道德的一个女人，不是。
It is also not the case that it's not the case that she's a very loose woman.
她是要应验以赛亚先知在700多年前所讲的预言。
But what happened to her was to fulfill a prophecy spoken by God in the book of Isaiah 700 over years ago.
我们来看23节。
In verse 23.
说必有童女怀孕生子，人要称他的名为以马内利。以马内利翻出来的就是神与我们同在。
Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us.
我们把书先放在马太二章，马太一章。
Let's bookmark Matthew chapter 1.
我们来看以赛亚书。
Let's look at the book of Isaiah.
以赛亚书的七章十四节。
In chapter 7, Isaiah chapter 7, verse 14.
以赛亚书七章十四节。
Isaiah 7 verse 14.
他说因此主自己给他一个兆头，必有童女怀孕生子，给他起名叫以马内利。
Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Behold, a virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and shall call his name Emmanuel.
这里很清楚的来去对照天使所告诉约瑟的事情呢，是要来应验以赛亚在700多年前所讲的、
and、
所预言的。
Reading these two passages, these two passages are in sync, and this is to tell us that what happened to Mary was to fulfill what was spoken by God through the prophet 700 over years ago in the book of Isaiah.
所以约瑟，你不要怕、啊。
Because of this, do not be afraid, Joseph.
玛利亚没有做什么事情对不起你，也没有做什么事情让你得到失望啊。
And Mary did not do anything that.Should cause you disappointment. She did not do anything that has wronged you. That brings wrong to you.
是神啊，选召了她来做这个事情啊。
But it's because God has chosen her to do this work.
我们不知道我们在读这一段的时候。
Not sure when we read this passage.
啊，当有人来问起我们的时候。
When people ask us.
我们会不会有惧怕呢
？Will we be afraid?
惧怕不懂怎么去回答他们呢
？We are afraid of how to answer them.
因为有人会问啊。
Some will ask.
真的吗？可能吗
？Is it possible? Is it true?
一个没有跟另外一个男生发生关系，能够生出孩子吗？可能吗
？Can a woman possibly conceive without a sexual relationship with another man?
那这可能不可能的事啊。
It's not possible.
那。圣经明明讲得很清楚啊。
Yet this is made evidently clear in the Bible.
玛利亚所怀的是借着圣灵。
That the conception of Jesus in Mary was through the Holy Spirit.
可是现在人怀疑哦。
But men cast doubts now.
所以也造成了我们不懂怎么去回答他们，对吗
？And because of this, we do not know how to answer them.
哦，他们就觉得说啊。或许我们换一个方式来想。
They start to think about alternative way another way to think about this.
啊，怎么可能这个玛利亚有罪，生出一个无罪的耶稣来呢
？How is it possible that Mary who has sin can give birth to Jesus who is without sin？
所以他们没办法去连接说这个是神的一个旨意，这个也是神的应许，这个也是神的一个预言。
They are not able to connect the dots to understand that this is the will of God. This is also the fulfillment of a prophecy of God.
所以呢，他们就想了一个办法。
And they thought of a method.
除罪。
To get rid of sin.
啊，把玛利亚封成圣母玛利亚。
And they decided to call Mary the Holy Mother Mary.
啊，那因为她是圣的，所以她生出来也是圣的。
And because she's holy, the baby that she gives birth to will be holy as well.
那就可以解释说啊，为什么耶稣啊没有罪了。
And that explains why Jesus is without sin.
可是这个对吗
Is this correct?
按照圣经来看，对吗？
From the perspective of the Bible, is this correct?
我们要从圣经去找答案哦。
So we have to find the answers from the Bible.
我们不要给别人所问了，问倒了，我们就惧怕，我们就不懂怎么回答。
Let's not be afraid because of the questioning of others and we do not know how to answer them.
因为圣经都有答案呐。
Because the Bible gives us answers.
我们也可以参考路加的一章三十五节。
Let's also look at Luke chapter 1 verse 35.
我们从三十四看到三十五节。
Verse 34 to verse 35.
三十四节。
Verse 34.
玛利亚对天使说：“我没有出嫁，怎么会这些事呢？”三十五节，天使回答说：“圣灵要临到你的身上，至高者的能力要隐蔽你，因此所要生的是圣者，必称为神的儿子。”
Then Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I do not know a man?" And the angel answered and said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the highest will overshadow you. Therefore also, that Holy One who is to be born will be called the Son of God."
所以这边啊，圣经在马太、在路加很清楚地告诉我们，就是圣灵要让玛利亚怀胎。
The Bible clearly says in Matthew and in Luke, that on the verses that we read, that Mary shall give birth to a son and is conceived through the Holy Spirit.
所以我们不要去质疑说，那玛利亚真的可以生出一个没有罪的耶稣吗？
So let's never doubt whether Mary can give birth to Jesus who is without sin.
圣经写的。
Because the Bible clearly records.
按照圣经去看，就是这样。
And if you read the Bible, this is what happened.
我们绝对不要去怀疑啊。
We should never doubt.
我们也不要给人家带走啊。
And we should never be led away.
啊，不要去，因为有人家问一些问题，说真的吗？可能吗？所以就这样怀疑，也惧怕，也不懂怎么回答。圣经有讲的很清楚。
Do not let the questioning of others shaken our belief, because this is what the Bible says.
就是因为这样，所以才能够生出一个无罪的耶稣。就是因为这样，他才可以做我们的救世主。
And it is because of how this is done, conceived through the Holy Spirit. That's why, we have a Savior who is born for us.
所以我们的神所讲的句句都是真实的，而且是真理。
Every single word spoken by the Lord is true, and it is also the truth.
所以我们也不要惧怕说我们不懂怎么回答。圣经有答案。
Let's not be afraid.How to answer? Because the Bible gives us the answers.
不需要透过人的这种方式啊，去解释说啊，没有罪的才可以生出无罪的耶稣来，不需要这样解释。
And it's not true the arguments made by man the arguments that how a holy one could be born from someone with sin.
因为这个是神老早在七百年前已经讲的。
Because this.Has already been spoken by God 700 over years ago.
所以我们今天呢，要清楚我们所相信的是什么。
Hence, we have to be absolutely clear in what we believe today.
我们不要有这样的一种错误的观念。
Let's not have this misconception.
所以约瑟在这个他认为玛利亚让他失望，让他背叛他，其实这些是不必要的一些惧怕。
These fears which Joseph had because he was disappointed or he felt betrayed, these are all unnecessary.
让我们知道说神是掌控一切，他是历史的一切。
Because God is in control of all things. He is the maker. He decides all history.
我们来看诗篇的三十七篇。
Psalm 37.
诗篇三十七篇，我们来看一到四节。
Psalm 37 verse 1 to verse 4. Psalm 37 verse 1 to 4. Do not fret because of evildoers, nor be envious of the workers of iniquity, for they shall soon be cut down like the grass and wither as the green herbs. Trust in the Lord and do good, dwell in the land and feed on his faithfulness. Delight yourself also in the Lord, and he shall give you the desires of your heart.
在这里这个作者当然是大卫本身啦，他是大卫的诗嘛。
This is a psalm of David.
我们不要看到这些世界的这些不平以及这些作恶的，看起来他们 好像没有受到什么审判这样。
And when we observe all the evil as well as the evil doers in the world, and they, it seems and appears that they have not received their own judgment.
但是啊，神必定会追讨他们。
But the fact is that God will pursue all the evil that they have done.
但是我们啊，必定要来依靠耶和华。
But for us, let us rely on the Lord.
我们要继续啊，做我们应该做的事。
Let us continue to do what we have to do.
让我们不要啊，心怀不平啊。
Let us not have this this imbalance in our hearts.
啊，直到啊这些事啊，会产生一些我们心理上的一些惧怕。
That these things cause us fears in our hearts.
啊，但是我们相信我们的神啊，是掌控一切。
Because we believe our God controls all things.
他一定啊会啊给我们一个啊公义的啊一个审判。
And he will definitely give to us his righteous judgment.
我们再来看呢、啊、第二个不要惧怕。
The second thing that we should not be afraid.
我们来看回马太一章的十九节。
Matthew chapter 1 verse 19.
十九节啊，她的丈夫约瑟是个义人，不愿意明明的羞辱她，想要暗暗的把她。休妻了。
So Joseph was a just man, not wanting to make her a public example, was minded to put her away secretly.
这边啊，告诉我们呐、啊，当然约瑟啊，因为看到这些事啊，当然也特别怕说啊，肚子一天天的大，哎，要是不把他休了，我也没有跟他发生关系，那怎么办呢？所以他的惧怕是来自什么呢？来自这些众人的议论。还有意见。
And here his fears was coming out of the judgment of others because you know he has no relationship with her yet, but yet her the Mary who was betrothed to him was pregnant and her because of that of the pregnancy it will show before others.
你不要说那个时候啊不能够接受哈。
Let's not talk about this is something that is not accepted at that time.
你要回到，要是我们在四五十年前了，在台湾。
Forty, fifty years ago in Taiwan.
要是有人因为还没有结婚就有关系了，而且呢，生下孩子了。
If someone, before marriage, really have a child and conceive and have a child.
这个是一个非常丢脸、非常羞耻的事啊。
It's something very shameful.
可是现在大家都认为说是很平常的事。
But for now, it is something which is viewed that it is normal.
大家都能够接受。
It is widely accepted.
你情我愿就好了。
As long as you both are willing parties.
你可以看到现今的这个道德啊，已经到了什么样的一个地步呢
？You can see the decadence of morality today.
要是那在四五十年前台湾，要是说。有一个明星真的是怀孕了，还没有结婚就怀孕了。
If a star, a pop star before he or she is married and start to before she is married, she has a child.
她可能啊就离开台湾了，不在台湾了。
And she will have to leave Taiwan. She will no longer be in Taiwan.
因为太羞耻了，太丢脸了。
Because this is so shameful.
所以呢，她就埋名啊。隐姓埋名啊，就离开了，就到别的国家去了，甚至不回来了。
She may not even come back. She may even change her name.
可是现在呢
？What about now？
啊，这些明星啊，怎么开始有这种婚前性行为啊？很光明正大的说，哎，我要结婚了。
And all these pop stars today, they have premarital sex, and they are very open to talk about this, and talk about this before their marriage.
他们不知道，或者他们不认为啊，这是羞耻的事。
And they don't think that there's anything shameful about this.
其实这个是违背圣经的教导。
This is contrary to the teachings of the Bible.
神要让你在有婚约里面来有这样的性行为。
Because sexual relationship is only permissible in a marriage.
不是在婚前，不是在婚后。
It is not before, it is not after.
在婚后只有你跟你太太而已。
After marriage, it is only permissible between spouses.
我必须要强调。
And this is something I have to emphasize.
因为现今的社会真的是很可怕。
Because society today is terrible.
他们不认为说这个是错啊。
Because they don't think that there's anything wrong.
他们认为没有事啊。
And they think that you shouldn't, there's nothing wrong with it.
这是违背圣经啊。
But this is contrary to the teachings of the Bible.
在那时约瑟他认为说啊，人家这样的来看啊，玛利亚，所以呢，他陷于在这个人的这种啊意见呐、啊，以及啊的事上。
And at that time, Joseph was afraid how others will look on him and Mary because of what has happened.、
因为在那个时候，要是被捉到的话，或许玛利亚就完了。
Because if others were to catch hold of her, that could be the end of her.
他也很担心说、啊、到底要怎么样
and he was wondering what to do.
所以他是活在、啊、这个别人的或者其他人的这种意见上。
So he was living, being influenced and affected by the opinions of the people surrounding him.
但是他万万没有想到说神这计划呢是要在玛利亚的身上。
He never expected that this plan was the plan of God.For Mary.
他只看到别人的议论纷纷，所以呢，他也没办法接受，所以呢，他要暗暗的把玛利亚休了。
He only heard, he only looked at all the opinions of others, and because of this, he decided that he would like to put away Mary secretly.
所以他会活在这种人的议论纷纷的这个事情上。
He lived in the expectations and opinions of others.
可是神。却有美好的计划。
Yet God has a beautiful plan.
很多时候啊，我们也会啊，活在人的这种议论纷纷。
Very often we in our lives we lead in the midst of the opinions and expectations of others.
啊，使到我们没办法展现啊神在我们身上的美好的旨意。
And this prevents us from manifesting the beautiful plan of God on us.
我们会怕人家怎么看我们。
We are afraid how others will look at us.
有些时候啊，我们或许啊，在我们的遭遇上，我们或许也不敢跟别人讲。
When we meet with something bad, we are afraid to share this with others.
我们不敢讲，是因为我们怕人家笑我们。
And we are afraid because others could laugh at us.
那也因着这种讥笑呢，会产生一些恐惧。
And we are afraid because of the laughter that we receive in response.
可是，要是我们是为了、要来做神的工
，But if it is for the purpose of doing the work of God，
要传扬神的福音
，If it is for evangelizing the gospel，
那我们不应该要有这种惧怕
，Then we should not have this fear。
人怎么看我们，这个不重要
，It is not important how others look at us。
应该是神怎么看我们才重要
，What's more important is how God looks at us。
所以，箴言这样讲
，In Proverbs。
箴言的二十九章二十五节。
Proverbs chapter 29 verse 25. Proverbs chapter 29 verse 25. The fear of man brings a snare, and whoever trusts in the Lord shall be safe.
箴言、很清楚地告诉我们、惧怕人、陷入网罗，唯有依靠耶和华必得安稳。
Fear of man brings a snare, whoever trusts in the Lord shall be safe.
我们很多时候我们会活在人的这种这种意见上，所以呢，很多事情不敢做。
We often live in the opinions of others, and this holds us back in doing the things that we have to do.
甚至我们在我们的工作岗位。
To the extent that in the roles we play in our careers in our workplace,
我们也会惧怕。
We are also afraid.
因为现在我们比如说有一些节日
，For example, if there are different festivals，
我们敢挺身而出，把我们所信的我们的信仰，我们能够在那个时候讲出来吗
？Are you able to state what you believe in your faith at that point in time？
还是我们惧怕，我们就埋名不讲？
Or are we afraid and we decide to hide?
我们怕说讲出来啊，啊，我们就会失去我们的同事，失去我们的朋友。
We are afraid that by saying and stating it out, we may lose our friends and colleagues.
我们会面对越来越多的这种违背真理、违背道理啊，这些啊所谓的啊不道德的事。
We'll meet with all these issues of immorality, and this will multiply more and more.
随着这个罪啊越来越严重。
With the growing severity of sins that are committed,
你会发现说我们会被被挤压。
And you will realize that we will soon be compressed into a corner.
因为大家都能够接受，为什么你们身为基督徒不能够接受呢
？And people will ask you and ask you this question: Why is it that others can accept you as a Christian can't?
啊，为什么你们的教会那么特别呢
？Why is it that your church is so special?
啊，为什么不能够庆祝圣诞节呢
？Why is it that you don't celebrate Christmas?
啊，为什么你们又不庆祝这个复活节呢
？Why is it that you do not celebrate Easter?
难道耶稣没有降生吗
Was Jesus not born?
难道耶稣基督没有复活吗？
Was Jesus not resurrected?
你会发现说我们会跟这个世界好像越来越远，好像有一个隔膜这样。
And it appears that we drift away from the world, and there's a chasm between us.
可是要是我们要来遵守神给我们的教导。
But if we are to obey the teachings of God,
当然我们就会跟周边的人呢有不同的看法咯。
Then we will have different opinions.Compared to those around us,
那周边的人就觉得说你跟我们不一样咯。
And those around you will look at you and say that you are very different.
那很多人觉得说，不要把圣诞节说成是一个异教嘛，哦，异教的一种庆祝嘛。
And there's a current saying that you know, on Christmas that don't treat Christmas as something which is paganistic.
其实他们都知道。
They know this.
我们现在要把它改成是一种爱的关怀的一种精神。
We have to change this spirit of celebrating Christmas to the spirit of caring for others.
我们不要谈什么异教啊，什么拜太阳神，这不要谈。
Let's not talk about the paganistic practices related to Christmas and the worship of the sun god.
可是我们从圣经去看的时候
，When we look at it from the perspective of the Bible.
耶稣基督有告诉我们要来庆祝他的诞生吗
？Did Jesus Christ ask us to celebrate his birth？
耶稣基督有告诉我们要来庆祝他的复活节吗
？Did Jesus Christ ask us to celebrate his resurrection？
耶稣都没有讲。
Jesus did not say。
耶稣只告诉我们。
Jesus only said to us。
也就是今天下午我们要来办的。这个圣餐礼
，and this is also the Holy Communion that we're going to conduct in the afternoon.
耶稣只告诉我们要纪念他的死。
Lord Jesus asks us to remember his death.
因为他的死跟我们的得救有绝对的关系。
Because it is only through his death, that we can be saved and is related to our salvation.
所以，要是今天我们活在人的议论纷纷，活在人的这种意见之下呢，当然我们很辛苦。也会产生不必要的惧怕。
And if we continue to live in the opinions of others, then we will have many fears and we will find it very difficult.
唯有我们来依靠神的话，遵循他的话，那把我们的立场讲出来，那我们才能够在我们的信仰上稳固。
Only by relying and trusting in the word of God and make it clear your stand, that then.Things will go well for you.
因为圣经没有写的，我们不应该加添了。
Because if this is not recorded in the Bible, let's not add.
而且我们也不应该用我们自己的方式去来解释圣经啊。
Let's not use our own our thinking to try to explain the Bible.
所以约瑟有他的惧怕，是因为他看到别人怎么去看这个事情。
Joseph was afraid because he was looking at how others the opinions others will have on this matter.
啊，今天啊，别人也会这样的，用这种眼光啊来看我们。
And in the same manner, people around us also have different opinions about us.
他也觉得说，我们是非常离群的，我们是不合一的。
You'll find that you you are not part of us. You are not like us.
但是我们要从圣经去看的时候，
but when we look at it from the perspective of the Bible,
当然我们要坚持我们所信的。
We have to hold on to what we believe in.
因为这是神教导的。
Because this is what the Lord has taught us.
我们是不可以改变的。
And we can never change this.
我们只可以守住那。只可以不在于人家的这种指指点点，还有他们的意见。
We must hold on to this in firm belief, regardless of how others will look at us.
因为我们要做神喜悦的事。
Because we have to be well pleasing before Him.
那我们的信仰才会能够稳固来成长。
Only then our faith will be firm and our faith will grow.
我们再来看最后一点。
The last point.
我们来看二十节。
Verse 20.
我们一章的二十节哈。
Matthew 1 verse 20。
正思想这事的时候，有主的使者向他梦中显现说：“大卫的子孙约瑟，不要怕，只管娶过你的妻子玛利亚，因她所怀孕的是圣灵来的，是从圣灵来的。”
Well, he thought about these things. Behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary, your wife, for what?" For that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Spirit.
这个最后一个惧怕呢，就是他精神上的这种痛苦。
And the last fear is the fear that is the result of mental torture.
Mental anguish. 好，那圣经说，当他在思想的时候，
When he was thinking about this,
也就是说，他很震撼呐，他不懂怎么办呐。
It shocked him. He didn't know what to do.
怎么可能呢？
How is it possible?
那我要怎么去面对呢？
How am I going to face this?
我怎么跟亲人讲呢？
What am I going to say to my relatives?
我是要把她休了。
I'm going to put her away secretly.
还是我怎么样？
Or what are my other options?
我相信在那个时候啊，我们可以，要是能够进到约瑟的心去体验的话呢，他真的是在那个时候真的是不懂怎么办。
And if we were to, we were able to enter the heart of Joseph, and you will be able to experience that at that point in time, he didn't know what a course of action to take.
他的那种心理的那种状态啊，里面啊，真的是在征战。
And there will be a war that is fighting in his mental state.
所以他的这种忧虑啊，他没办法去处理啊。
And these anxieties that he had, he did not know how to manage it.
那他也不想让玛利亚因着这样被人家指指点点，或者说遭遇不好的事。
And it's not he didn't want for Mary to suffer all the accusatory looks of others.
那他也怕说玛利亚的名字会被因着这样来被羞辱了。
And he was also not.He didn't want Mary's name to be shamed because of this matter.
所以这些啊，都造成他不必要的这些忧虑啊。
And this caused unnecessary anxieties in him.
但是我们可以看到，玛利亚，她名字不但没有被侮辱。
Not only did was Mary's name not shamed.
她的名字啊是有福的。
And his name was blessed.
因为
her name was blessed.
因为她要生出这个救世主。
Because she is going to give birth to the Savior.
所以她的这种精神上的这种所谓的惧怕是不必要的。
His mental fears were unnecessary.
可是当天使还没有告诉他的时候，他当然会怕。
But before the angel said this to him, he will be afraid.
我们很多时候。也会像约瑟这样。
Very often we are like Joseph.
有很多不必要的这种精神上的这种创伤啊，是我们因为对神没有信心啊，所以所产生的。
Psychologically we are hurt, because we do not have that faith towards God.
当然我们进到这种情境，很自然的我们会有惧怕。
And when we are in that state, it is natural that we will have fears.
因为我们是人。
Because we are only human.
我们看不到未来。
We do not know the future.
我们也不懂未来会怎么样。
And we do not know what the future beholds for us.
唯有能够看到未来的这位主啊，掌控一切的知道。
But we only can see our Lord who is who beholds who is the Lord of the future, that he is in control of all things.
所以要是我们遇到这种精神上的这种惧怕的时候，我们该怎么办呢？
What are we to do when we have this psychological fears?
我们该回到我们的神。
We have to return to our God.
我们应该要告诉我们的神我们里面的惧怕。
We have to say to our God the fears that we have inside.
因为精神上这种惧怕呢，是让我们呢没办法睡，也没办法没办法睡，也没办法过我们正常的生活。
Mental and psychological fears rob us of our sleep and prevents us from leading a normal life.
我们不要以为这个是小事哦。
And let's not think that this is something that is minute.
你一天两天不睡觉还 OK 哦。
If you have insomnia for 2 days, that's still all right.
你长时间没办法睡。
If you have insomnia for many days,
那你的这个免疫系统，你的整个身体啊的状况都不好。
There will be a physiological impact, including your immune system.
所以这个是会造成我们身体上的整个不好的事。
And it causes negative physiological impact.
所以我们面对这样的一个困境的时候
，When we are in this difficult state,
尤其是在精神上这种挫败或者创伤的时候
，Especially the psychological hurt that we experience.
我们应该回到神那里去。
Let's return to God.
而且只有神啊才能够来帮助我们。
Only God can help us.
在我们教会有很多这样的一个见证啊。
There are many of these testimonies in our church.
那睡不着啊。
When they say that I can't sleep.
那该怎么办呢？
What am I going to do?
那小弟也讲过这个见证很多次啦。
I said this testimony several times already.
啊，就有个姐妹啊，睡不着啊。
There was a sister who could not sleep.
那她也不知道啊，她突然间就想到一句话啊。
And she remembered this phrase.
就是有一句话这样进到她的脑海里。
And this phrase, this words entered her mind.
啊，就是约翰的16:33.
And this is recorded in Gospel according to John chapter 16:33.
约翰16:33.
John 16:33.
我们请念。
The things I've spoken to you, that in me you may have peace. In the world you will have tribulation.But be of good cheer, I've overcome the world.
这句话他说在世有苦难，但你们可以放心，我已经胜过了世界。
That in this world you have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I've overcome the world.
这个姐妹受到了精神上的这种困扰。
This sister was very troubled psychologically.
那她没办法入眠。
She was unable to sleep.
可是他说，当这句话进到他的心，这下半段的这句话嘛，但你放心，我已经胜过了世界。
When these words be of good cheer, I've overcome the world entered her mind, her heart.
这个话就安慰了他。
And these words comforted her.
在那一刹那，他就能够入眠了。
And at that moment, she was able to fall asleep.
这个姐妹亲口跟我讲的。
This sister said to me.
她说，传道，这个到底是谁讲的？
Who said these things?
怎么那么有力量呢？
How is it that it's so powerful?
我说啊，这个是耶稣讲的话啦。
And I said to her, these are the words spoken by the Lord Jesus.
她还以为说是什么有名的人讲的话。
And she thought that this was spoken by someone famous.
我说不是，这是耶稣讲的。
And I said to her, no, it is spoken by Jesus.
难怪我能够睡得着。
And it is no wonder that I could fall asleep.
因为这是神的话，是真理，是不改变的。
Because this is the word of God, it is the truth, and it never changes.
耶稣基督也告诉我们，我们的确会遇到困难。
And the Lord Jesus clearly tells us that you will face tribulation in the world.
但是你们可以放心啊。
But let's be of good cheer.
因为我已经立了榜样给你们来学习啊。
Because the Lord Jesus has set an example for us to follow, to learn from.
因为我要给你的平安不是世界所给你的。
Because the peace I give you is not the peace that the world gives.
所以你能够因着耶稣基督的应许啊，来安然的来度日。
And you are able to continue living your life because of the promises of the Lord.
因为他已经立了榜样，他也因着这样来得胜。
He has set an example and he has overcome the world.
所以我们也照样的能够循着耶稣基督给我们的榜样来去做。
So we can follow his example he has set for us.
我们或许今天会遇到很多精神上的这种挑战。
Perhaps we face many of these psychological challenges today.
有如约瑟这样。
And we are like Joseph.
哦，我们也可以，我们也会深深的去思考。
And we can think about this deeply.
但是你们放心。
Be of good cheer.
因为我们的耶稣基督要赏赐永恒的平安给我们。
Because our Lord Jesus will grant us everlasting peace.
所以你今天需要什么？
What do you need today?
你需要的是不要怕。
You need not be afraid.
因为你已经在耶稣基督的怀里，你已经在耶稣基督的应许之下。
Because you are in the bosom of the Lord Jesus, you are in the under the promises of the Lord Jesus.
当你在惧怕的时候，
When you are afraid.
神会在你的惧怕中来遇见你。
God meets you in your fears.
相对的，他也是在约瑟惧怕的时候来遇见他。
And in the same manner, God met Joseph in his fears.
所以我们就来看一个圣经章节。
The last verse.
我们来看彼得前书的五章七节。
First Peter, chapter 5, verse 7.
彼得前书五章七节。
First Peter, chapter 5, verse 7.Casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you.
我们要对彼得长老给我们的这个勉励有绝对的信心。
We must have absolute faith of what Elder Peter has to say to us here.
他没有说把一件两件，他说把一切一切的忧虑都交给神。
He didn't say cast some of your cares. He said all of your cares.
为什么交给他，我们就不用担心呢
？Why is it that we will not be anxious after we cast our cares on him.
因为他知道我们不过是尘土所造的。
Because God knows that we are made of dust.
所以他知道我们有这样的软弱，他也知道我们需要他。
He knows our weaknesses. He knows that we need him.
所以他因他顾念我们。
And because he thinks of us.
所以求神来带领我们。
May God guide and lead all of us.
求神来帮助我们。
And help us.
我们来唱诗。
Let's sing him.
382首。
Sing him 382.